गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ जयदीप पारेजिया। आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन वीपी इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज राजकोट। ओके, सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव्स। अमंग दिस टॉपिक्स विच दिस आर द टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस टॉपिक्स। ओके, अमंग फर्स्ट थ्री टॉपिक्स वी हैड ऑलरेडी सीन इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर। एक्चुअली दिस इज द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ दिस टॉपिक्स। First three topics we already covered in our first lecture. So today we have to start with fourth topics. So let us start with the definition of concavity. Okay, concavity: a function f of x is defined on closed interval ab and differentiable on open interval ab, then it is called concave up if f dash of x is increasing function on closed interval ab, and it is called concave down on closed interval ab if f dash of x is decreasing on closed interval ab. Okay, let us see one example. So that f of x is equal to x cube is concave up on open interval 0 to infinite and concave down on minus infinite to 0. Let us try to solve this example. Side please. Sorry, table top please. Let us first try to show that f of x is equal to x cube is concave up on 0 to infinite. For that we have to show that f dash of x is increasing function on this interval 0 to infinite. F of x is equal to x cube, so f dash of x is equal to 3x square. Our aim is to prove 3x square is increasing function on this interval 0 to infinite. Let x1, x2 belongs to this interval be any two arbitrary point with the property x1 is less than x2. We will prove that f dash of x1 is less than f dash of x2. Now we have x1 is less than x2 implies x1 square is less than x2 square. We can write like this because x1 and x2 are positive quantity. Reason is x1 and x2 is greater than 0. So x1 square is less than x2 square implies 3x1 square is less than 3x2 square. But what is 3x1 square? This is our f dash of x1, and 3x2 square is our f dash of x2. So we start with x1 is less than x2 and reached at f dash of x1 is less than f dash of x2. This proves that f dash of x is increasing function. We will use this symbol for increasing function on this interval 0 to infinite. That is, f of x is concave up on 0 to infinite. Now we'll prove that f of x is concave down. Now we will prove that f of x is equal to x cube is decreasing function, sorry, concave down on minus infinite to 0. Let x1 comma x2 be any two arbitrary point from this interval minus infinite to 0 with the property that x1 is less than x2. Now we have x1 is less than x2 implies x1 square is greater than x2 square. Why? Because x1 and x2 is less than 0. So equality will change. Okay. Implies 3x1 square is greater than 3x2 square. But what is this 3x1 square? This is our f dash of x1. Similarly, this is our f dash of x2. So we had start with x1 is less than x2 and reached at f dash of x1 is greater than f dash of x2. This proves that f dash of x is decreasing function. So this proves that f dash of x is decreasing function on minus infinity to 0. That is, f of x is, this proves that f of x is concave down on this interval minus infinity to 0. Okay, it is not always easy to prove f of x is either concave up or concave down using this method. For that we have one extra test, namely second derivative test for concavity. Let us see it. Let f of x be any twice differentiable function on an interval I. Then if f double dash of x is greater than 0 on I, then f of x is concave up on I. And if f double dash of x is less than 0 on I, then f of x is concave down on I. Example. Determine the concavity of f of x is equal to 3 plus sin x on the interval 0 to 2 pi. We will use second derivative test for concavity to solve this example. Now we have f of x is equal to 3 plus sin x. So f dash of x is differentiation of 3 is 0 and differentiation of sin x is cos x. Implies f double dash of x is differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. Okay. We know that sin x is increasing function in first two quadrant, that means in the interval 0 to pi, okay, which implies that minus sin x is decreasing function on this interval 0 to pi. But what is this? This is our f double dash of x. Minus sin x is our f double dash of x. So f double dash of x is decreasing function on this interval 0 to pi. Okay, so using second derivative test for concavity, we have f of x is concave down on this interval 0 to pi. Okay, now we will prove that this function f of x is equal to 3 plus sin x is concave up on the interval pi to 2 pi. Now we know that sin x is decreasing function on third and fourth quadrant, that means in the interval pi to 2 pi, implies that minus sin x is decreasing function on this interval, increasing function, because we multiply with minus sign, so equality will change. So increasing will becomes decreasing function. So here sin x is decreasing function on this interval pi to 2 pi. So minus sin x is increasing function on this interval pi to 2 pi. But what is this? This is again same things. F double dash of x is increasing function on this interval pi to 2 pi. So f double s of x increasing function in this interval. So it proves that f of x is concave up in this interval. This proves that This proves that f of x is equal to 3 plus sin x is concave up on this interval pi to 2 pi. Let us see the graph of this function. Side please. Graph of this function, you can easily see that function is in concave down on the interval 0 to pi and concave up on the interval pi to 2 pi from the help of this graph. Okay. Now next definition is point of inflection. Definition of point of inflection is a point on the graph where function has a tangent line and where concavity changes is called point of inflection. If we see the last figure, then at this point pi comma 3 is the point on the graph where function changes in concavity. It is concave down to concave up at this point pi to 3. So pi comma 3 is the point of inflection for this f of x. Okay. Now next example is tabletop, please. Find the point of inflection of f of x is equal to x is to 4 minus 2x square. Okay, let us try to solve this example. We have f of x is equal to x is to 4 minus 2x square. So f dash of x is 4x cube minus 4x. So f double dash of x is 12x square minus 4. If we put f double dash of x is equal to 0, if we put f double dash of x is equal to 0, then we have 12x square minus 4 is equal to 0, which implies that x square minus 3x square minus 1 is equal to 0, implies x square is equal to 1 by 3, implies x is equal to plus or minus 1 upon root 3. So this may be the point of inflection. Let us check whether it is a point of inflection or not. Okay. For that, it is convenient to make a table like this. We have 2 points plus or minus 1 upon root 3. So it will make 3 interval, minus infinite to minus 1 upon root 3. Second interval is minus 1 upon root 3 to 1 upon root 3. And last interval is 1 upon root 3 to infinite. Okay. Let us make a table. Intervals, sine of f double dash of x, and nature of the function. We have three intervals. First is minus infinite to minus 1 upon root 3. Second one is minus 1 upon root 3 to 1 upon root 3. And third one is 1 upon root 3 to infinite. How can you find sine of f double s of x in this interval? By just evaluating value of f double s of x only at one point, any point, you can choose any point from this interval minus infinite to minus 1 upon root 3. Choose any point from this interval minus infinite to minus 1 upon root 3. For our conveniency, we take x is equal to minus 1. Then find f double s of minus 1. F double s of x will not change sign in this interval. So f double s of minus 1 is equal to, we have f double s of x is 12x square minus 4. So f double s of minus 1 is 12 minus 1 square minus 4. This is 12 minus 4, 8 is greater than 0. So sine of f double s of x is greater than 0. So function is increasing in this interval minus infinite to minus 1 upon root 3. Now we'll find sine of f double dash of x in this interval minus 1 upon root 3 to 1 upon root 3. For our conveniency, we choose x is equal to 0. Now find f double dash of 0. F double dash of 0 is 12, 0 square minus 4. This is minus 4 is less than 0. So sine of f double dash of x in the interval, in this interval, minus 1 upon root 3 to 1 upon root 3 is less than 0. So function is decreasing on this interval. That means concave up. In this interval, function is concave up, and here is function is concave down. Okay. Now we have to find out sine of f double dash of x in the last interval, 1 upon root 3 to infinite. Choose x is equal to 1, which lies in this interval. So f double dash of 1 is 12, 1 square minus 4, this is again 8, is greater than 0. So here sine of f double dash of x is greater than 0, that means function is concave up. Now see here, at this point, minus 1 upon root 3 to 1 upon root 3, function changes concavity. It is concave up to concave down at this point, minus 1 upon root 3 to minus 1 upon root 3. At minus 1 upon root 3, function changes concavity. It is concave up to concave down. Similarly, at this point, this is the common point in these two intervals. And at this, point, function changes concavity from down to up. So these are the point of inflection, minus 1 upon root 3 and 1 upon root 3. So, at 1 upon